Hi, it's Brian from iSpring, and today we're going to find out how to customize the quiz player. You can go to the player customization options right here from the toolbar. This is a fully interactive preview, so you'll see exactly what your final quiz will look like. The player consists of everything outside the quiz slides themselves, including buttons like this Start Quiz button on the intro slide. Once you get into the quiz proper, you can see some more elements on the top bar. Let's see how to toggle these elements. There in the upper right corner, you can show the point value of the current question and a running total of the score as the quiz progresses. Now I'll answer a few questions so you can see what happens. I'll get one right, one wrong, and one kinda right. Now you can see the results in this question list up here. And these three columns can be toggled with the three checkboxes down here. You can also choose to just show the question numbers or not show anything at all up there. Now let's hop over to the colors. You can pick a preset from the list or fine-tune the colors yourself and save it as a custom preset here. If your quiz is on a PowerPoint slide, you can make the background transparent with this checkbox. The background is everything outside the player. You can also make the player area transparent as well. Now let's go to the text labels. All the player text can be changed here, and again you have a built-in list of presets. Like the colors, each text can be fine-tuned, or you can translate everything to your own language and save it as a preset. Once you're done fine-tuning your player, you can export all the settings to a file, which you can share with a colleague who can import it here. You can also reset the player to the default settings with this button. When you're ready to get back to your quiz, click Apply and Close. Thanks for watching. Now you're ready to play with the player. Did you like this video? Give it a like and subscribe to the iSpring YouTube channel for more updates.